Hello, welcome to my student support system. In today's class, we will discuss about leukemia. This lecture is in English, and if you want to study in Hindi, just click on I button and you will get link of Hindi lecture, or you can directly visit to channel my student support system. What is leukemia? Leukemia is defined as neoplastic proliferation of any type of blood cell, mainly granulocyte, monocyte or lymphocyte. The defect originates in the hematopoietic stem cell, that is myeloid or lymphoid stem cells. In other words, we can say that leukemia is unregulated proliferation of leukocytes or other cells in the bone marrow or blood cancer. So today we are going to discuss blood cancer or leukemia. What is the classification of leukemias? The leukemias are commonly classified according to the stem cell involved, either lymphoid or myeloid, because from these two types of stem cells, all blood cells are developed. They are further classified as acute and chronic, as you can see this in this classification chart. First of all, we will discuss about AML, means acute myeloid leukemia. Acute myeloid leukemia results from the defect in hematopoietic stem cell that differentiate into all myeloid cells that are monocytes, granulocytes, which includes neutrophils, basophils and eosinophils, and erythrocyte and platelets. In the prognosis, patient's age is a significant factor. Patients who are younger may survive for more years after diagnosis of AML than older age persons. Clinical manifestations of AML. Due to proliferation of abnormal cells, the production of normal cell is reduced. This results in many clinical manifestations such as fever due to infection, because there is neutropenia. Neutropenia means the number of neutrophils are less in the blood, which protects our body from infection. When they are less, there will be infection and fever is resulted. Weakness and fatigue due to anemia, because RBCs will also be less. Bleeding tendencies, and mostly the bleeding occur in the gastrointestinal tract, pulmonary system, and intracranial bleeding are common due to thrombocytopenia, means less platelets in the blood. Patches and purpuras on lower extremities due to thrombocytopenia, means subcutaneous blood is escaped and they deposited in the subcutaneous tissue or just below the skin. Pain from enlarged liver and spleen, pain in gums, bone pain due to expansion of bone marrow. Complications of AML includes bleeding and infection, and these are the major cause of death due to AML. Treatment of AML. Treatment of AML includes aggressive administration of chemotherapy. It is also called as induction therapy. It usually requires hospitalization for several weeks. Induction therapy typically involves high dose of cytarabine and donirubicin or mitoxantrone or IDRE are missing. The aim of induction therapy is to eradicate the leukemic cells or cancer cells of the blood. Along with chemotherapy, supportive treatment is also provided, which includes administration of blood products as per need, such as RBCs, platelets, promptly treating the infection, and the use of granulocyte growth factors, either GCSF or GM-CSF, because these can stimulate the bone marrows to produce normal leukocytes more quickly. Another treatment option is bone marrow transplant and peripheral blood stem cell transplant. Second type is chronic myeloid leukemia or CML. Chronic myeloid leukemia is caused by a mutation in myeloid stem cell. In this type of leukemia, normal myeloid cell continue to be produced, but there is increase in production of some abnormal cells. In 90-95% of the patients with CML, a section of DNA is missing from chromosome 22. This is due to this mutation. What clinical manifestations are there due to CML? Due to uncontrolled proliferation of cells, the marrow expands into the cavities of long marrow, long bone, such as femur, and cells are also formed in the liver and spleen. That is also known as extramedullary hematopoiesis, resulting in enlargement of these organs, and later become painful. Other symptoms include shortness of breath, confusion, malaise, anorexia, and weight loss. Treatment of CML includes an oral formulation of tyrosine kinase inhibitor, imatinib mesylate. Imatinib therapy appears to be most useful in the chronic phase of the disease. Another treatment option is again bone marrow transplant or peripheral blood stem cell transplant. Acute lymphoid leukemia. So next type is ALL. Acute lymphoid leukemia, or which is also known as acute lymphocytic leukemia, is caused by an uncontrolled proliferation of immature cells that are known as lymphoblasts from the lymphoid stem cells. Beta lymphoid lymphocyte acute lymphoid leukemia found in approximately 75% of the cases, while T lymphocyte acute lymphoid leukemia occur in only 25%. Acute lymphoid leukemia is most common in young children. Clinical manifestations. Due to uncontrolled proliferation of immature cells, the production of normal cell decreases, which results in clinical manifestations such as pain from the enlarged liver or spleen and bone pain. The central nervous system involvement may result in headache and vomiting. Treatment of ALL. The treatment of acute lymphoid leukemia includes preventive cranial irradiation or intrathecal chemotherapy with methotrexate, because acute lymphoid leukemia frequently invades the central nervous system. Systemic chemotherapy also involves the anthracyclines along with corticosteroids. Another treatment option is bone marrow transplant or peripheral blood stem cell transplant. And next type is chronic lymphoid leukemia or CLL. Chronic lymphoid leukemia or chronic lymphocytic leukemia, both name are same, is quite common in older people. It is mainly a malignancy of B lymphocytes. T lymphocyte involvement is very rare. In contrast to acute form of lymphoid leukemia, most of the leukemia cells in chronic lymphoid leukemia are fully mature. Clinical manifestations. Most patients with CLL are asymptomatic, but when sign and symptom appear, they include fever, drenching sweats, especially at night, unintentional weight loss, life-threatening infections, and painful lymphadenopathy. Means lymphoid tissues are swollen. Treatment of CLL. Treatment of CLL includes the chemotherapeutic agents such as fludarabine and cyclophosphamide, which are often given in combination with monoclonal antibody rituximab. Bacterial infections are common in the patients with CLL, so IV treatment with immunoglobulins may be given to the selected patients with recurrent infections. Diagnostic investigations. For all types of leukemias, first of all, history and physical examination gives a hint for leukemias, and then for definite diagnosis, complete blood count is done, and bone marrow biopsy is very important for confirming the type of leukemia. Nursing management. For all these types of leukemias, nursing management will remain same. First of all, proper assessment is done by taking health history and proper physical examination. A nursing care plan is prepared. Closely monitor the client for signs of bleeding and take steps to control bleeding because it may become life-threatening. Apply direct pressure to control the bleeding on the point of bleeding. For epistaxis, position the patient in high Fowler's position and apply ice pack to the back of neck and direct pressure on nose. Apply and notify the physician if prolonged bleeding is there. Means if you are unable to stop within 10 minutes, then physician should be notified. Administer platelets, fresh frozen plasma, packed red blood cell as prescribed. All medications are given on time and patient's response is recorded in nurse's notes. The patient should be encouraged to discuss and to participate in the management of leukemia and to ask their questions and concerns. Fatigue is a very common symptom in leukemia, so nursing intervention should focus on assisting the patient to establish a balance between activity and rest. Use a high efficiency particulate air filter mask, HEPA, the patient can ambulate or walk around outside the room despite severe neutropenia and risk for infection. Patient should be encouraged to sit up in the chair while awake rather than just staying in the bed or lying. Even this simple activity can improve patient's tidal volume, respiratory status, and enhance blood circulation. Intake and output chart should be maintained, they should be measured, and daily weight should also be monitored. The patient should be assessed for signs of dehydration as well as fluid overload. Balance should be maintained. The patient should be encouraged to do as much as possible activities to preserve mobility and functions as well as self-esteem. He should be encouraged to maintain personal hygiene himself. The patient and family need to have a clear understanding of the disease, the prognosis, and how to monitor for complications and reoccurrence. The nurse ensures that this information is provided. The nurse should respect the patient's choice about treatment, including measures to prolong life and other end-of-life measures. Being diagnosed with leukemia can be extremely frightening providing emotional support and discussing the uncertain future are crucial to alleviate anxiety. During discharge planning, the health education should be provided to patient and family, and it should focus on the disease, its treatment, prognosis, home care, and certainly the resulting significant risk for infection and need for follow-up. Thank you students for watching this video. You can subscribe channel for latest updates. You can like Facebook page. And for making your notes, you can visit mynursingstudents.blogspot.com. You can follow me on Twitter, Instagram, and join Facebook group Nursing Notes. Thank you. Have a nice day.